Hey, Tom, welcome to New Jersey 101.5. How are you?
Good morning, Bill. How are you?
So, Tom, I understand that there's a little story that you, even as a retired cop, sometimes you still have to come to someone's rescue.
Absolutely, yes. My neighbor, Jen. Oh, good morning, Jen.
Good morning, Tom. How are you?
So what happened?
All right.
So Tom is my neighbor.
Yes.
So go ahead, Tom. You tell the story.
You tell it probably better. But
well,
let
Jen set it up to
I'll
the point when Tom saw you.
All right. So I have a teenage son, and he locked his bedroom door one night. I couldn't get in because he was playing video games. And I said, it's time to go to bed, blah, blah, blah. So I said, I'm going to be the smart one. I'm going to take a screwdriver and unlock the door. And I'm not handy at all. So I broke the doorknob.
Okay.
Broke it from the outside. So now him and I are laughing, whatever. So the next morning, I take him to school. I realize I forgot something. I come back home. I go in his room to get it. I don't know what happened. The door closed behind me. I was locked in.
You locked yourself in your son's room.
I locked myself in his room.
Because you broke the lock.
From the outside, but from the inside, it just slammed into
you
the
door. You
and
your son must have a good relationship if he was laughing.
He was laughing.
With the screwdriver.
Totally laughing.
Because I would have taken some issue with that if my mother had broken into my room with a screwdriver.
So,
anyway.
I didn't have a cell phone because I left everything in the car because I was running in really quick to get it. No way to get out. So now bright me thinks I'm going to break the screen off the window and jump from the roof of my condo. Because I thought I could do it.
Tom, at what point did you see this damsel in distress?
I woke up around 6:30 in the morning to the sound of, I thought, was kids going off to the bus stop. And I look out the window and no children. And I know everybody in the neighborhood. And it's really not the time for the kids to be out playing. So I go back to bed and I don't think anything of it. So a minute or two later, I hear something again. I said, okay, let me go to the other bedroom. I open the window and look out the back of the house. I still don't see anybody, but I heard this voice. I said, I don't know where it's coming from. So I go back to bed. Next time I hear it, a few minutes later, I said, I'm going downstairs. I open the door. Now I'm listening through the screen, and I finally hear someone saying, help!
I was like, anybody, Tom, where are you? You're supposed to be my savior. But Tom comes into the house, and then what happened?
Right.
Well, so I walk outside, and you know, in a shorts and t-shirt, and bare feet, and I look, and she said, "Tom, help me, please! I'm stuck in the room." I said, "Jim, what are you doing?" She says, "The door is locked." I says, "You can't pull the little lever on the door, even if the handle's off, to get it open." No, and she's, you know, half in tears.
Tom does hysterical. A good Jen Ursillo.
He does, and I was crying. I was totally crying.
So, yeah, how long were you in there?
It was a good 20 minutes to a half an hour. Before Tom decided to come help me. But in my defense, Tom, when you came upstairs, you couldn't open the door. You had to break it down.
Yes. She told me where there was a screwdriver on the other side, but the way the handle was broken, normally without a doorknob, you could still reach in with a screwdriver and slide the piece forward. It would turn the knob. It would open.
Oh, my God. All right, so have you fixed the door since,
no,
Jen?
No, there's still no doorknob on it.
Unbelievable.
But, Tom,
okay, you said you had a doorknob. I'll put it on for
I
you.
Do have it. I just didn't put it on yet.
See that? This is what we do on the morning show. We solve problems. Tom has now offered to fix the doorknob for you.
Prior
so, like,
to
this
that,
story
handyman.
Has
a... Bill, I'm a regular handyman.
I was going to say, Tom, I'm thinking this is not the first request you've had.
No, my cat killed a mouse in my bedroom. And I had to get Tom to come out and remove the dead mouse. I wouldn't touch it.
Tom, I got to tell you, man, you're the kind of neighbor everybody wants. Like, everybody should have a retired police sergeant as their neighbor.
Yes.
I love it. I love it.
Oh,
yeah,
I
changed the battery in a smoke detector.
He did.
For her.
My closet fell apart. He came and fixed it. I just keep using the poor thing.
Trim the bushes for her.
I'm learning so much about Jen Ursillo right now.
I got locked in. I was
my
scared.
My whole image has changed.
Oh, God. Bill, I couldn't get out.
She's a capable girl. She's just, she likes to play the damsel in distress.
That's where I was sort of driving at that a little bit.
Wow. Well, I put up my own Christmas tree. I didn't even ask for your help, Tom.
He did the lights.
No, I did my own lights.
Did you really?
Yes.
All right. Well, Tom, listen. Hey, how many years did you serve in the force?
25.
25 years. God bless you. Are you enjoying retirement or do you miss it?
I do miss it. Yeah. I didn't miss it the first number of years, and then after that, yeah, you do miss it. You miss the camaraderie. You don't miss all the bad times, but you miss the good times with you know, your brothers and sisters, and you miss the times when you can do some good thing to help some people. You try to make a positive out of it when it has a lot of negative built into the job.
Yeah, it's true.